to present a research on the chronology of the Bronze Age Mokrin Necropolis. So it's a little bit different study, a bit more specific than these other studies, and it's how relative and absolute chronology could be maybe complementary, and it maybe opens more questions than it answers. So the research was done by me and my colleagues from the laboratory of bioarchaeology at the University of Belgrade and Bias Institute in Novi Sad. And let me start with the brief info about the necropolis. It is one of the necropolis of the so-called Maroš cultural group that spanned in the modern days northern Serbia, Romania, and Hungary. And so it was discovered in 19th century, but it was excavated in 1950s and 1960s. Most of the graves contained incremented remains of a single individual, but there are some exceptions, so three graves with double burials and one with triple. And the funeral ritual is quite standardized. So we have all the remains are in crouched position and oriented east. So there are different previous studies, and these are some of them. These are monographs. So this is one example of the burial. And there are different grave goods found in these graves: ceramic vessels, weapons, jewelry, and animal bones. And here you can see some of the examples of grave goods. And the interesting thing is that Oshé suggested that some of them could be markers of social status. So, for example, copper daggers or bone tools or some jewelry. concerning the chronology, besides the fact that numerous research was done on this necropolis, there are only 6 radiocarbon dates for these 312 graves, and here you can see the spans, and the thing is that they overlap quite greatly. And besides that, they're located mainly in the western part of the necropolis. But as we know, chronology is important for different reasons, and to explore the spatial temporal organization of the necropolis, changes in material culture, studies of ancient DNA that are currently being done, and the study of cultural connections, innovations, and so on. And the thing is how to date the necropolis with 312 graves, and we have only 6 dates, and we will need quite a lot of additional dates, but that is currently not possible. So we decided to create relative chronology and check its reliability with absolute dates. And besides improving our knowledge possibly on chronology, we could make a strategy for further absolute dating. So here is the list of previous studies on relative chronology. And it was mostly qualitative research, so it was based on development of ceramic forms, but so choosing few types in different parts of necropolis, also largely on analogies. So as you can see, for example, here, where Sarasano was comparing the vessel shapes with vessels from firmly dated perium site. And there are researchers also like Oshé or Rega that considered that neglected the chronological part of the necropolis. They thought that the necropolis was one occupation phase and that you have only social differentiation. That is the only spatial pattern. The only quantitative studies done so far was by Wagner, and she did the occurrence seriation of metal finds, and so it was from 30 or 40 graves, I think, and concluded that the orientation, the spread of necropolis was from southeast to northwest, as did the most of the previous researchers. But we wanted to reassess this question of chronology by seriating the ceramic forms from the site, and we have chosen the most common types of vessels, so bowls, one-handled and two-handled pitchers, and amphorae. We use morphometry and statistics to saved the ceramic vessels, and here you can see some of the attributes that we recorded during our analysis. So we have taken 10 widths of the vessel, which would approximate the vessel shapes. We also measured height of the handles and the maximum width of the hands where possible, and standardized all the measures, and we also taken some qualitative attributes, as you can see here. To proceed with seriation, we applied the two seriation techniques, phyletic seriation, and we used PCA, which was suggested by Shannon, to get the chronological ordering of the individual vessels, and also multidimensional scaling on Gower's index, which can incorporate both qualitative and quantitative data. But as we got very similar results, so I will present only PCA here in this presentation. We also did frequency seriation by spatially grouping graves and seriating using corresponding analysis. We explored some spatial patterns and tried to validate the results with existing radiocarbon dates and by using analogies. So, yes, I forgot to say that we plotted medians of all the dates just for the sake of clarity. And here you can see the results of the PCA. And the assumption is that the chronology would run along the first principal component. But this didn't happen in our research, and so it's quite mixed. You can see here that the dates are completely mixed. Also here, the dates that are quite far away are close to each other in space. And so only for 100 pitches, we got some possible chronology, but with only three dates, it's hard to say something more about it. And here you can see some of the examples of like the extreme values of PC, PC1. So that could be some kind of change in vessel shape if it was a chronology, but we're not sure about it. Next, we want to see if similar vessels from PC, with similar shape, are grouped are close to each other in space. So then we did k-means cluster analysis to get some types, like with question marks, like to get some to spread the variation. And you can see here how it looks in space. There are certainly some spatial patterns, but this is far from clear. For example, you have type 3 located only in southern part of the necropolis, or here, or for example, type 1 here that is spread all around, but so no clear spatial patterns that we observed. And we also did Mantel's test to test formally this correlation, and it has really low values. The only significant correlation is between balls, but the thing is that this correlation is very low. So our conclusion would be that either the correlation is very weak or that it is not non-linear. Then we proceeded with the frequency seriation. So we clustered the graves by their coordinates, and we got 15 groups, and we used again topology using k-means clustering, as you can see here again. We counted the types in clusters and got some like small assemblages. So spatial cluster 1 has some, for example, three vessels of types 4 and so on. And so with this, we could proceed with correspondence analysis. And these are the results of correspondence analysis. So it's not a perfect seriation solution, but it's interesting that we have the youngest date on one side of the necropolis and all the other clustering like on the other side. So this could be a chronology. And then we wanted to see again if there are some spatial patterns, if these groups that are similar, like with vessel types, that if they are located in the same part of the necropolis. And this is what we got. So again, there is some spatial patterns. So the vessel, the clusters that are similar are close to each other. And this could be a chronology, but it's hard to say with 6 dates. We also compared with our results with some analogies. So, for example, natural ceramics should be located in the older part of Necropolis by previous research, and it is like roughly that way. So they're like catching these first two phases, possibly. And Dansalonet handles are supposed to be younger and related to Middle Bronze Age, but and so if this is a chronology, they would be, we would expect them to be here, but they are in the central part of the necropolis. So compared with previous research, we got somewhat similar results. So it's the chronology would be southeast northwest, but we think that the picture, emerging picture, is more complex. So that we have, for example, maybe first phase this way, second, third, and fourth, and but of course we would need more research to confirm our results. And so we got with phyletic seriation, we didn't get any clear results. With frequency seriation, we obtained possible chronology, which roughly supports the previously proposed chronology. And but we think that the spatial-temporal pattern of graves is more complex. Of course, we will need additional radiocarbon to confirm our results. But we think that radiochronology, especially in the case of necropolis, where you would have to obtain quite a lot of additional dates, could help to make a firm chronology and maybe even make a strategy for further sampling. And we think that both relative and absolute dating should be used for making chronology, especially in such complex cases as necropolis. So that would be all. Thank you.